Namaste. Welcome to the UGC's e-Pathshala program for post-graduation studies. I am Anita Khanna and I teach Japanese in Jawaharlal Nehru University. Besides the language, I also teach literature and culture. Let's begin today's lesson. Today's lesson is on Zen Buddhism, and the title of paper is Paper 4, The Heroes of Japanese Literature, Culture, and Other Topics. Zen Buddhism is a part of our cultural heritage, especially between India and Japan. The disseminations of yesteryears resulted in conspicuous presence of India in Japan in various aspects, life, faith, etc. This could be made possible in ancient period when there was no modes of transportation. The presence of Indianness or Indian culture in Japan could primarily be attributed to Buddhism. There is a famous work, Kiku to Katana, The Chrysanthemum and Sword, in which there are few references to the Zen meditation. According to the author, many civilizations have developed techniques of meditation of this kind, but the Japanese goals and methods have a marked character, all their own. This is especially interesting because many of the techniques are derived from India, where they are known as yoga. Japanese techniques of self-hypnotism, concentration and control of the senses still show kinship with the Indian practices. There is similar emphasis on emptying the mind, on immobility of the body, on 10,000 repetitions of the same phrase, on fixing the attention on a chosen symbol, etc. Even the terminology used in India is still recognizable. Beyond these bare bones of the cult, however, the Japanese version has little in common with the Indian religions or Hindu or Hinduism, unquote. What is Zen? The dictionary meaning is given as, the origin of Zen is dhyana, from Sanskrit, which means meditation. It was transcribed as chan in Chinese. In Japanese, this word was transcribed as Zen. However, Zen doesn't exactly coincide with the Indian dhyana. Dhyana is generally translated as meditation, but it is really the practice of mental concentration in which the reasoning process of the intellect is cut short and consciousness is heightened by cessation of extraneous thoughts, except for the one which is taken as the subject or the phrase for the meditation. Thus, in dhyana, one approaches the plane of pure thought and attains enlightenment. In case of Zen, there are many interpretations of the word. Zen meditation cannot be confined to any particular practice. According to Denkyo Daishi, who's known as Saicho and founded the Tendai sect of Buddhism in Japan, appraised Zen as a genuine Buddhist teaching introduced by Bodhidharma from India to China. Bodhidharma lived during 460 to 528 AD. So like this, we know that the origin of Zen in Japan is Chan in Chinese. And Chan is a transliteration of the word Dhyana. And since Dhyana has been integral part of Indian meditation and religious traditions common to most of the religions of it, Dhyana constitutes the core of ascetic practices, mainly based on meditation, austerities and contemplation. It has inspired the practices of Zen or Zazen, associated with Indian Samhadhi, and Zazen is associated with Zen meditation. Now, how did Zen or Chan develop in China? In China, it was introduced by an Indian monk named Bodhidharma. Bodhidharma went to China in 520 AD, and his teachings were developed as a distinct school under the influence of native Taoism. Not much is known about Bodhidharma in India, except for the fact that he was the 28th patriarch of the line of Buddha's closest disciple Mahakashyapa and third son of the king of Koshi in South India. It is believed that he was already 60 years old when he undertook the arduous journey to China, where he stayed in Shaolin Temple and transmitted Zen Buddhism there. His teachings also included the practices of Zazen as an integral part of Zen. In Shaolin Temple, he stayed for 9 years, meditating on a wall while constantly gazing on it, and so he was named or came to be known as Hikikan Baramon, the wall gazing Brahman. Hikikan Baramon. It is evident that the Zen practices mostly focus on contemplation and concentration and meditation rather than prayers, rituals, discourse, or any metaphysical observations. And these were associated with Heian Buddhism, were popularly practiced as Kaji Kito, the name, the equivalent of which is given in the Japanese English Dictionary of Buddhist Terms as Adhishthan. Now in Nara period, there were 6 oldest Buddhist sects which emerged, but out of those, 2 were based on Zen practices. One was Rinzai sect and the other was Soto sect. Rinzai sect founded by Eisai and Soto sect was founded by Dogen. Yet the conspicuous presence of Zen in Nara period did not come a long way. It was only in the Kamakura period, when the army generals came to prominence and Zen caught the attention of warriors. As we all know, that Kamakura period is one of the turbulent periods after a long era of peace during the Heian period. And the key word which describes is the Mujokan or the impermanence. Coming back to Zen, in Zen what is emphasized is the strict monastic discipline, Vinaya, and the practices of Dhyana. This caught the fancy of warrior class of Japan, especially due to its emphasis on focusing upon the mind rather than complex metaphysical introspections. According to it, every man has a Buddha nature, and one can realize and discover it by introspecting, by looking within oneself. This inner realization is called Satori in Japanese, and it could be achieved through the meditation which is called Zazen. As we all know that even in Indian tradition of Dhyana, a person who has controlled over oneself and has tamed his mind could be the rightful candidate. In other words, only those who have prepared oneself, their body and mind, to go into the trance and undertake meditation can succeed. Likewise, in the Japanese work Fukan Zazengi, written in 1228, Universal Promotion of the Principles of Zazen, the title in English. This work was by the Zen master Dogen, and he points that Buddha was born with great wisdom, and yet he had to sit for 6 years in meditation. Likewise, Bodhidharma transmitted the Buddha mind, which he had obtained through the practices of his 9 years of wall gazing. In other words, one has to prepare oneself to succeed in this sphere. How Dhyana reached Japan? Buddhism, as we all have studied, introduced to Japan through Korea, followed by an active transmission from China through the exchange of official missions called Kentoshi. With Buddhism, its religious thought, philosophies, scriptures, icons were handed down along with the various rituals and ceremonies and the practice of Dhyana. At that time, in China, several new schools of Buddhism had cropped up. But it was Zen that completely disregarded the scriptures and images. In the words of renowned scholar of Zen Buddhism, Dr. D.T. Suzuki, according to him, when we come to Zen after a survey of the general field of Buddhism, we are compelled to acknowledge that its simplicity, directness, pragmatic tendency, and close connection with everyday life stand in remarkable contrast to the other Buddhist sects. Undoubtedly, the main idea of Zen are derived directly from the Buddha. According to the Zen way of meditation, one has to stop following words. Just quit following words and letters, withdraw and reflect on one's own self. If one is able to cast off body and mind, naturally the Buddha mind emerges. One has to make an early start in order to obtain it. In Japan, it was monk Eisai who lived during 1141 up to 1215, and monk Dogen who lived between 12,000 AD to 1253 AD endeavored to popularize Zen in such a way that it developed as a vital part of Japanese culture and tradition. Zen Buddhism was strengthened time and again by the Japanese monks who went to study to China as a part of the official delegations. By 12th century, it was firmly rooted in Japan as an independent Buddhist sect under the patronage of the army generals and came to be associated with the warrior class. This could be achieved through the efforts of monk Eisai. What is the principle of communication in Zen? In Zen, the principle of communication is silence. Silence is emphasized, which requires years of practice and concentration. The core concept is Dhyana, through which one could be with oneself, whereby one's true self, that is Tatha, and it is revealed through it. Zen teachings are based on the scriptures like the Prajnaparamita Sutra, Vimal Kirti Nirdesha Sutra, etc. In Japanese, they are Hokkekyo and Yuimakyo, and has contributed a lot to the Japanese culture. Let's have a look at Zen Buddhism and Japanese culture. Zen monks introduced a new wave of Buddhist culture. In Zen, the heavy baggage of studying the scriptures, etc., was discarded. Instead, the focus was to calm the mind and contemplate within oneself. The key word is harmony. Harmony in body, breath, and mind. This fresh wave of Zen Buddhism caught the fancy, as we all know, of the newly risen warrior class. And dhyana was considered to be an important practice also in esoteric Buddhism, whereby the practitioner concentrates on some object like a symbol, mandala, icon. But it was only as a part of Zen Buddhism that dhyana could develop as an independent form of religious practice. Zen Buddhism was highly instrumental in introducing a new dimension to not only the religion and philosophy, but also to art, culture, and literature of Japan. The Zen monks avidly practiced and introduced new elements which they learned from China. The military generals of the medieval age, in turn, patronized and promoted Zen with a great zeal. For example, Kamakura period, monk Eisai introduced Rinzai sect of Zen, and it provided spiritual support to the warrior class and helped to establish Bushido, a code of conduct for the warrior unique to Japan. Bushido in English is the way of warrior. Zen monks are also known to have contributed for preserving Japanese education and culture. They also trained and educated common people in their temples called Terakoya. The Zen monks developed educational institutions like Ashikaga School. They also set up libraries containing volumes of Zen and Confucian works. The traditional art, besides the martial arts, were also practiced at the Zen monasteries. The writings of that age deal with bulk of material written dealing with the Zen, especially the Zen sayings. And there is a corpus of literature called Gozan Bungaku, literature of the five mounts, which illustrates how drawn and refined style of paintings in monochrome called Suibokuga, calligraphy, discourse in questions-answer style called Koan, Sado, the tea ceremony, Kado, the flower arrangement, etc. were developed. Koan is a unique philosophical practice based on the questions and answers of the Zen masters. Just like original teachings of Buddha evolved and were handed down through discourses rather than documentation or rituals, the Zen practitioners too primarily relied on training and control of the self without laying any importance to scriptures. Yet the logic and discussion were recorded for the benefit of newly ordained monks and discussions that has come down to us as koan. In koan, the narrative unfolds in the form of dialogue centered around such problems like who's carrying one's lifeless body? All things return to one. Where does this last return? Koan were used by the Zen practitioners and clergy as a means to initiate a philosophical discourse. it could be called a Setsuwa-like narrative dotted with allusions to explain the essence of the message. The Chinese term Kung'an became Koan in Japanese as the popularity of Zen Buddhism in China led to the transmission of Zen to Japan, Korea as well. In Japan, it was monk Eisai who developed Koan, and so there are Koan works on thematic problems through discussion among the masters and disciples. In the process of studying and contemplating upon these in the company of the master, the disciple experiences sudden spiritual awakening. After some weeks or few months or sometimes a few years, in the end, some accidental occurrence, a sound or a scream takes place that works as a catalyst to enable the follower to attain the ultimate realization. Here I take one example of Koan. A monk was always carrying around with great reverence a golden image of Buddha and other relics. Even when in the assembly hall or dormitory, he constantly lighted incense to them and showed his respect with prostrations and offerings. One day the Zen master said, "The Buddha image and the relics that you are worshipping will be of no use to you later." The monk disagreed. The master continued, "This is the handiwork of demons. You must get rid of these items at once." The monk became indignant and started walking away. The master called after him, "Open your box and look inside." When the indecisive monk stopped and looked in the box, he found a poisonous snake coiled inside. And here the koan is concluded. The theme is based on the supernatural phenomenon, acts of the evil creatures that trouble the master, miraculous happenings, ghosts, spirits, landscape, etc. Zazen. Eisai's disciple Dogen, the founder of Soto sect, introduced the practice of Zazen. Dogen was critical of Zen for its extra strenuous emphasis on the mind itself. So he introduced Zazen practice as a form of concentration while sitting in meditation. Zen meditation while sitting in cross-legged asana is called the Zazen. The practitioner sits in Vajrasana or Sukhasana and meditate by looking within in order to control the mind and ultimately to be one with self, muga, with no delusions at all. In Japanese, it's called Zazen, and it is the primary ritual for Zen monks. A person learns to concentrate. Zen is based on the assumption that all human beings are bestowed with the Buddha nature, Bussho, and one has to look within to realize it. And the Zen seeker can find the light within himself by his own effort, by clearing and removing the obstacles by oneself, even if it amounts to be posed by Buddha himself. Therefore, there is a Zen saying which is famous: if you meet Buddha, kill him. If you meet the patriarch, kill him, because they come in the way of realization of yourself. Killing is more of a metaphorical, which means in the method described by Dogen in his Fukan Zazen Gi, he gives the details as: it is important to focus your attention on hara. This hara is placed within the body, located 2 inches below the navel. It is physical and spiritual center of the body. one is needed to put one's attention and mind there. As one develops in Zazen, one is conscious more and more of Hara and will experience spiritual awakening or enlightenment, that is Satori." Unquote. Monk Esai also introduced another practice, which is of drinking tea in Japan, and it has come down to us as Sado or the Cha no Yu. Tea was regarded as the most nourishing drink for human beings by the Zen monks, and they developed tea drinking as an aesthetic and appealing experience in the form of tea ceremony. This Sado was especially popular among the army generals, and they made beautiful yet simple tea houses surrounded by the serene landscape and gardens, with a hearth inside the room on which the water was boiled in artistically designed kettle and offered in equally artistic tea bowls. Tea bowls and other implements used for tea ceremony were tastefully created pieces of art, usually also imported from Korea and China, and treated as, or rather treasured as, objects the art by the owner of the tea house. Esai also wrote a work, Kissa Yo Joki, Drink Tea to Improve Health and Prolong Life. With the building of tea houses, the other arts like Ikebana or Kado, which was arranged in the tea room, also scroll paintings of calligraphy, which were decorated the alcove in the room, and that made the simple yet symbolic landscape of the tea rooms. It was the Senno Rikyu who was the father of tea, or the Sado, the art of tea drinking, and it was his farsightedness that the simple tea drinking could be developed as elaborate and highly artistic ritual of unparalleled style. Zen monks mostly spend their time in reading and writing in Chinese or Kambun. Their prose and poetry writings are called Gozan Bungaku, the literature produced in the five mountain monasteries of Zen. This was written mostly between the 14th to 16th centuries. These writings and poetry centered on secular subjects rather than religious discourse, like the poet Matsuo Basho of haiku poetry, a short verse of seven syllables arranged in the form of 5-7-5 and also adapted in Zen Buddhism. In a poem by Dogen, the founder of Soto sect of Zen, the poet, while describing the daily routine or dincharya at a Zen monastery, refers to the daily chores of brushing one's teeth in a poem chanted as a prayer in the morning. Here the toothstick he used for brushing the teeth is referred as a twig of willow tree, and having chewed it by one third, he chants as follows: "While chewing a toothstick at dawn, I vow with all beings to care for the eyes and teeth that white through all afflictions." Nevertheless, in medieval Japan, Zen was the most powerful and dynamic school, which nurtured and cultured roots and martial arts as the symbols of Japanese culture. In the final analysis, Zen is a disciplined way of life which entails not only the physical but also spiritual aspect. Today, it has a large following in Europe and America as well, and it is the fact that the Zazen is inspired by the Indian yoga tradition. It helps to, in modern times, to remove the stress and anxiety.